Yo, check this out, look, it's 10:32 right now.
What I'm about to do, I'm about to go put work in the gym, man, while everybody's sleeping, man. I'm working. Grind don't stop, you know what I mean, man? Everybody's sleeping, talking to their girl, man. This is my girlfriend right here. You see, that's my girl right there. I love you.
My personal opinion, one of the toughest guards in the city. Definitely one of the hidden gems. There's so much talent in the city like I got to overlooked. But he's out in North Carolina doing his thing. You know, he played with me this summer. He's one of my strongest players. Definitely one of the strongest guys. I see him go. A lot of guys with bigger names, and I think when he goes to college, his name's going to ring bells. Definitely remember the name.
Person that had to accompany me was my great grandfather. He used to take me almost every day right after school. I'd go up to him and ask him, "Hey, can you take me to the park?" And he, you know, in a wheelchair, he would accompany me. So that kind of meant a lot, and that kind of motivated me. And it hurt when he passed away right in front of me. That was probably the worst day of my life, man. Cause you know, I didn't have nobody else to go to take me to the park, or you know, just be there. You know, have a friend there. And it's gotten me to this point right now.
My circle real small. You know, most of my bros, they're not even friends. They family.
My boy Dante, bro. My boy Joel, man, aka the Flyers. My Flyers cousin, man.
Welcome to God.
Man. What? Man, every sneaker y'all know, you got it, man. You got it. Great, that's my boy Jay Stacks. Woof. The best, aka the best tattoo artist in East Harlem.
My boy Elvin right here, he's up next.
Out to my boy John. It's my Washington Heights buddy, man. You know, we from the Washington
Heights. Heights work.
My boy Washington Heights, John. My cousin David right here, man. My boy, man, too.
He's up next, man.
AKA the best lefty, man, right here, man.
He's crazy, man. He's gonna be up next.
Tell you, that's my boy right there.
Started playing ball at the age of 5. I mean, you know, I was just doing it for fun. Middle school years, you know, we have like recess or whatever. I go straight to the gym, try to shoot around. You know, I wasn't really nothing. I was always a short guy who was always underlooked. I didn't really have a name. Nobody really knew who I was until I really started taking basketball serious. And that was probably around my, you know, junior, sophomore year of, you know, high school. Freshman year, you know, I made the team, but I was riding that bench, you know, watching everybody play, you know, just studying everybody the way all these cats played. And I was like, you know, I really wanted to be the best. Being the underrated guard I am is still pushing me to be the best I could be and, you know, play against whoever. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're the best, the number one, the number two, top 10 player on ESPN. Still gonna play my game. You know, going through all of that kind of like shaped me to who I am and what I'm gonna be.
You don't want zero problems, big fella.
Yup. If one more label try to stop me, it's gonna be some dread. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it.
Yeah, that's when I transferred to a private school up in Connecticut, Westport, Connecticut, called Greens Farms Academy. You know, I did my thing there. You know, I left a good impression there. Only reason why I left was because I didn't feel like I was getting the right amount of exposure there. I was getting the good academics, but the exposure wasn't there. The exposure that I needed wasn't there. And so I decided for my senior year, I was going to take my talents to North Carolina to a school called Fort Shull Academy. You know, ever since then, I mean, my name's been ringing. Shout out to Coach Phil. You know, he's helped me a lot, you know, develop my game, shooting, you know, bringing out the, as he say, bringing out the dog out of me, you know. He's been there calling me every night, you know, making sure that I'm doing good in terms of like the recruiting process, making sure that there's, you know, college coaches there. Also shout out to my head coach, Coach Antonio Lowe. Man, he's helped me throughout the entire process, you know, in terms of like making sure the college coaches are there to watch me. So I really appreciate that. And, you know, after going to that school and still being part of that school, I've learned a lot, man, and that's mental toughness and, you know, working hard every day, no days off. And thanks to Coach Antonio and Coach Phil, Coach Ronnie Billups, the head coach at Denver University, came out to watch me, and he loved my game. He loved what I was doing and what I brought to the plate and, you know, how I could translate that into their system in Denver. And so about 2 weeks later, prior to when he came, they offered me a scholarship. That was my first Division I basketball scholarship. You know, I was getting calls from, you know, Providence. He spoke to the coaches at Wichita State. But, you know, going to Fort Shutt Academy, it opened up that Denver University door, and I took the offer. I used to feel so devastated.
To my families, my friends, my fans who supported me through everything. Thank you. This is my statement here.
And all I ever took was patience.
I do this for my great grandfather.